Hi everyone, my name is Deborah Stine. I'm a professor of the practice in engineering and public policy and associate director for policy outreach at the Scott Institute for Energy Innovation at Carnegie Mellon University. Welcome to this lecture answering the question, how should you develop and evaluate your policy options? In this lecture, we'll explore the steps used to develop, analyze, and compare policy options, define the key policy option criteria, the four E's, and discuss the differences between an advocate and an analyst. This video will provide you with guidance as to how to conduct steps 3 to 7 of the BARDOC 8-step process for policy analysis. In it, you'll learn how to construct policy alternatives, select the criteria to use for an analysis where you will project the outcomes of different policy alternatives, and then, using that analysis, you'll then confront the trade-offs among the options that will ultimately lead to a recommendation to your policymaker. You've probably heard of 3D printing, also known as additive printing, where a three-dimensional object is made from a digital file by putting layers of thin material, typically plastic, on top of one another. This technology has great promise for use in almost every industry and great economic potential. Yet there is a potential downside about this emerging technology as illustrated in this article. Among these challenges are the high amount of energy used, concerns about ultra-fine particulate emissions, and a reliance on plastics in an era where there is a goal of using less plastics in our daily lives. Imagine that you're working for the head of a federal environmental agency. They see the news report about this journal article that indicates the need for more ventilation and more research, and ask you to develop an analysis as to what policy option makes the most sense, keeping in mind the economic and societal potential for this burgeoning industry. What policy action would you recommend, and how would you decide? Pause the video a moment, read this excerpt from the journal article, and write down what you would do. Back. So what did you propose? Was it regulation? That is a frequent response to such a scenario, but it is important to understand that government does much more than regulate. Here is a list from BARDOC's Policy Analysis book that illustrates a variety of options available. For example, there could be a tax on 3D printing that reflects its impact on the environment, an information campaign to make more people aware of the concerns about particulate matter and 3D printing, or grants to 3D printing in businesses to install vending equipment, and many other options. In generating policy options, it is best to look at a list like this and brainstorm as many ideas as possible. Then, based on what you know about the situation, begin to narrow your analysis down to 3 options, the status quo, that's no action, plus 2 other alternatives. And how do you do that? By examining each option based on the positive and negative aspect, the pros and cons, for each policy using the 4 E's criteria: effectiveness, efficiency, equity, and ease of political acceptability. There are many criteria that can be used, but these 4 are generally the most important to your policymaker and should be considered in all situations. The first E is effectiveness. Is the policy likely to work? Will it achieve the societal goal? Face administrative barriers, and so forth. For this assessment, you may be able to use data from program evaluation studies of similar initiatives in other countries, cities, or states to evaluate a policy option. Program evaluation is discussed, though, in another video in more depth. The second E is efficiency. This looks at the economic cost of the option relative to the benefit to see if the policy option is the best bang for the buck. In this case, cost-benefit analysis may be available or developed to evaluate a policy option. Cost-benefit analysis is also described in another video. The third E is equity. In this criteria, we're looking at the fairness of the policy. There are always winners and losers for any policy. Who are they in this situation, and to what degree is the situation inequitable? The fourth E is ease of political acceptability. Here we are focusing on how government officials and other policy actors will appraise the policy. We're looking to see who is likely to oppose or support the policy and to what degree they are likely to do so. An analysis method useful in this situation is print analysis, discussed in another video. Going back to our 3D printing scenario, here are 3 possible options put together by one of my former students. The first option is always a status quo.
no additional action beyond existing regulations that already focus on energy and environmental aspects of a technology. For example, there are already regulations that are part of the Occupational Health and Safety Administration that focus on workers breathing hazardous substances. As mentioned in an earlier video, this is often the option picked in the end. The second option would be to allow industry growth while supporting more research and information gathering. And the third option would be to limit industry growth until the situation is better understood. The next step is to evaluate each policy option independently using the four E's by creating a matrix. One option is illustrated here is to put a positive sign if the goal is likely to reach, a negative sign if it's unlikely to be reached, a zero in situations where the positive and negative aspects are likely to balance each other out, and a question mark if there's insufficient information to evaluate this situation. You can always add multiple symbols to indicate degree if the situation looks particularly strong or negative. The next step is to do a pro-con analysis for each option for each criteria, illustrated here for the status quo. A common mistake is to focus on effectiveness or only look at the reasons why policy is a good idea, the pros. But it's also very important to examine the cons, why a policy might not work relative to given criteria. Otherwise, you're not an analyst, but an advocate. And even if you are working for an advocacy organization, you need to understand the critiques of those opposing your policy in order to either respond to them or negotiate a compromise. By filling in this table, you can produce your summary analysis. For example, on the pro side for effectiveness, we know that there are existing regulations in place today that may be sufficient. But on the con side, we don't know if those regulations are implemented or enforced. As a result, our summary analysis is a question mark. We don't have sufficient information. We continue this process for each of the criteria. A key principle to keep in mind if you're having a hard time thinking of cons is that if your idea is so great, why isn't it happening now? Or alternatively, imagine you are the person in charge of implementing the policy option. What would you need to do to make it happen? What challenges would you face? This then leads to a summary assessment for all the criteria. Here is an assessment of the status quo situation, where the major strength of this policy option is its ease of political acceptability. So although its effectiveness is unknown, and people may still be affected by the particulates, it's likely to be approved, particularly as there no additional cost is involved. This same process continues for the second option, more research, which has unknown effectiveness but low cost for implementation. The policy is likely to have high ease and political acceptance because of a similar activity that was supported for nanotechnology that has proved successful for that emerging industry. In addition, it is likely to have the support of non-governmental organizations who are concerned about the impact of 3D printing. More research might not be equitable, however, as people might still be impacted by the particulate matter while the research is being conducted, which may take a number of years. For the third option, limiting the growth of the industry, the option is likely to be effective in limiting emissions and thus perhaps more equitable to the public, but it will be very difficult to find sufficient support from industry and those employed directly or indirectly in the field. The next step is to put all the summary independent assessments together and confront the trade-offs among the policy options in a matrix. Looking at this matrix, we can see that of the three options assessed, the one with the overall more positive assessment is the more research option. The key criteria differentiating the analysis is ease of political acceptability, as this option does not adversely impact industry, but does respond to concerns about 3D printing. In addition, there is an existing successful model for policy, which increases its chances for success. Now, this is the result if you weighted all the criteria equally. Your policymaker, however, might say that one criteria might be more important than another. Say the efficiency. Say they want the option with the lowest cost, or the most politically acceptable, or the most equitable. If that is the situation, you might shift the recommendation you make to your policymaker. So in summary, to conduct a policy options analysis, you need to identify a full range of options, analyze those options based on criteria, and then confront the trade-offs to make your recommendation to your policymaker. The key criteria are the four E's: effectiveness, efficiency, equity, and ease of political acceptability. And while an analyst identifies the pros and cons of each policy, advocates only identify the pros, the reason a policy is a good idea. Here we're focusing on being an analyst, not an advocate.
Thank you for watching, and I encourage you to watch the other videos in this series.